Bleach. Remove the bleach. Next, I take a sterile distilled water to rinse the plants. And I'm going to rinse the plants 3 times. All right, I have rinsed the plants 3 times using a sterile water. Now it's time to cut them. So the first thing that I want to do is get rid of this extra water that I have. So always before you open the jar, spray the jar and your hands with alcohol. Let's discard the water. Being careful not to lose any of the plants. Let's move that to the side. All right, so now I want to take a sterile plate. To cut my plants. I only need one. There we go. So I have a clean, sterile surface to cut my plants. So I want to take my forceps out of the sterilizer and let's set them down so they cool down. Also, I want to take my scalpel and my blade. I'm going to put the blade in the scalpel. Like this. Now again, before I do anything, I want to spray my hands. Open the jar. Take my forceps. Take the cuttings out of the jar. Take my blade, and I'm going to cut them. So I don't need them to be this long. So I just want to cut this one on this side. The other one, I also want to cut it. And this one is good to go. This one as well, going to do the same thing. I want to cut from the both sides where the plant was exposed to the bleach. This helps to prevent some of the phenols coming into the media. Although I'm already know I want to have some phenol problems with this plant, so my media that I'm going to be using has some charcoal that's going to help absorb some of those phenols. And if you don't know what phenols are, basically it's like plant blood, so that's kind of reaction that the plants get from cutting the plants, so it's kind of like blood. There we go. So you want to prevent that in your tissue culture media. There we go. So I have my 4 cuts to sterilize my tools. I want to take my test tube. Like I say, it has this media is just MS media, but it has charcoal on it. It has charcoal on it, so it can absorb some of those phenols. So I'm going to take my plants. It's hard to tell which side is up and which side is down. I should have made a reference. I'm just going to set it like this. There we go, and then just let it sit in the test tube. I like to use test tubes instead of like a larger containers, because test tubes uses very little media, between like 15 to 20 milliliters of media. And if the plants get contaminated, then I don't waste more media, so I only use very little media. That's why I always recommend beginners when doing, or not even just beginners, I think everybody to when starting cultures to start them in a, something small like a test tube or like a petri dish. So I have the third one, have one more. And this media is fairly solid for these plants, but that's okay. There we go. And there we go, that's how it looks. So that's the Monstera Albo. And I hope in a few weeks, we're going to start seeing some new growth on the plants. All right guys, so placing Monsteras in a tissue culture is actually a very simple process. The sterilization usually works very well, between 25 to 30 minutes sterilization with 10% bleach. Usually works very well. Monsteras are usually plants that I like to use in my, in the houseplant tissue culture masterclass. So this I have a very good protocol on how to sterilize this plant. So we're going to wait a few weeks. Hopefully we're going to see some new growth coming from this plant, because that plant was pretty much almost dead. I think if I have left it for a couple, a week or maybe 2 weeks, the plant would have been completely dead. So I hope you have enjoyed it. I will see you next time. If you are interested in learning how to do plant tissue culture, make sure to check the link down below. You can get to the online tissue culture masterclass. I will see you on the next time. Goodbye. Thanks for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested on conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.